In this video, we can discuss about microscope. It's an important topic of pharmaceutical microbiology of third semester BPharm. In this topic, we will discuss in detail about the introduction, history of microscopy, terms that are regularly used in the microscopy like resolution, refractive index, contrast, and magnification power, and detailed structure of different type of microscope, light microscope, dark field microscope, phase contrast microscope, and electron microscope, in which transmission and scanning electron microscope in detail. Now coming to the introduction of microscopy. Microscopy is a technique for producing visible images of structures or details of two small objects that cannot be seen by human naked eye. So it can be studied by using a microscope or any other magnifying tool. Or more specifically, we can define this microscopy as is a technique of using microscope. The term microscope was originated from a Greek word, that is micros means small and scopion means to look or to see. And by using microscopy, we can study the microorganism in live state or as after the fixation. By hanging drop method, we can study the shape, arrangement, motility, and size of cells. Now coming to the history of microscope, the first scientist who discovered or invented a microscope was Robert Hooke in 1655. He designed a compound light microscope with a magnification power of 42 times that of the objects. And by using this microscope, he studied a thin slice of cork, and which leads to the discovery of cell. And he was the one who postulated the smallest unit of living cells are little boxes or cells. After that, Antony von Leeuwenhoek in 1676, he designed a single lens light microscope with magnification power of 300 times, and he observed the protozoa, bacteria, and fungi by using Antony von Leeuwenhoek. Now we will discuss some terms which are regularly used in microscopy. First term is resolution. So while describing any one microscope, we will tell on it have a resolution power of this. What is mean by that? So resolution is the ability of a lens or any magnifying tools to distinguish two points. That means if a microscope with a resolving power of 0.4 nanometer, it indicate it can distinguish two points which are separated by a distance of 0.4 nanometer or greater than that. And this resolution power can be increased by decreasing the wavelength. So shorter wavelength of light will provide greater resolution power. Now let's see some resolution power of some magnifying tools. Our eye, human eye, have an 0.2 millimeter. So you have to focus on the unit also. Light microscope have an resolving power of 0.02 micrometer, that means 10 raised to minus 3, and scanning electron microscope up to 5 to 10 nanometer, and transmission electron microscope of 0.5 nanometer. So from this, which one have more resolution power? Of course 0.5 nanometer have more resolving power, because by using transmission electron microscope we can distinguish two points which are separated by 0.5 nanometer, means 0.5 into 10 raised to minus 9 meter distance point we can be identified as two separate points. So that is the resolution. Now second term is refractive index. It is a measure of bending ability of a light in a medium. So it can be also measured by measuring the velocity of light at which the light passes through the material. As the refractive increases, light bending property will decreases. So the light may bend in air so much that it misses the small high magnification lens. So if we didn't use the oil in oil immersion, the light will not enter into the objective lens and it will not focus any object. So refractive index of air is 1 and refractive index of oil is 1.5. Now next term is total magnification or magnification power. It is the magnification power of an magnifying tool or any microscope, which is equal to the magnification power of eyepiece multiplied by objective lens magnification power. It is not the sum of eyepiece magnification plus objective, it is the multiplication of eyepiece magnification and objective lens. Okay, now next term is contrast. Contrast means the difference in the intensity between two objects or between an object and background. The staining process we are using is to increase the contrast, to give a colored microorganism or object in a uncolored background. So that is why we are performing staining process. And also a contrast is an important factor which will determine the resolution power of a microscope. Refraction is the bending of wave when it enter a medium where its speed is different. So it will occur when a light transfer from air to glass or glass to air or glass to oil. So there will be a bending property of light that is known as refraction. Next one is diffraction. So it is the bending of wave around the corner of an obstacle, or it occur when a light wave passes by a corner or through a opening or slit that is approximately size or even smaller than the light wave. That means when we place any objects on the path of a light, some light will bend over the obstacles. That bending property is known as diffraction. Now next one is reflection. It is the changing direction of wavefront of an interface. So sometimes some rays will contact with the object and it will get reflected. Now transmission, some moving or movement of electromagnetic waves through n material. So what will happen, some of the light waves will be absorbed due to the high density of the matter and rest of the rays or light rays will be transmitted through the object. So these are the different terms which are usually discussed in microscopy. There are many classes of microscope mainly classified according to the source of light or electron. So according to the light source, it is classified into light microscope. Light microscope is again classified into compound light microscope, bright field microscope, dark field microscope, phase contrast microscope, fluorescent microscope, confocal microscope, and differential interference contrast microscope. If it is the source is electron waves or electrons rays, it is known as electron microscope, and it is again classified to transmission electron microscope and scanning electron microscope. In our syllabus for third semester BPharm, we have to study in detail about dark field microscope, phase contrast microscope and electron microscope. Now coming to the light microscope, even though we don't have this topic in our syllabus, it is the basic structure of a microscope. After knowing the basic structure of a light microscope, it will be very easy to some modification in dark field and bright field and phase contrast microscope, so that we have to study the basic of light microscope. So light microscope, the source will be bright light, and we will use some set of lenses arranged on to focus the images. And the specimen which we are studying must be thin as much as possible. And there are different type of microscope, as I mentioned before: compound, bright field, dark field, phase contrast, fluorescence, and confocal microscopy. Coming to the compound light microscope, if the compound microscope have two ocular lens, it is known as binocular, or if it is only one eyepiece lens, it is known as monocular. And usually the light microscope have a resolving power of 0.2 micrometer and a magnification power of 200 times. And by using a light microscope, we can study both live state as well as after fixation of the microorganism. So this is a basic structure of a light microscope. First of all, let me clear one thing. We don't have to draw any compound structure of microscope in answer paper or for your examination purpose. This is just for to describe what are the different parts of microscope, and I will let you know that which diagram you have to write it or draw it for your examination. So microscope, from starting from bottom, it have a base. This is the base, and we have a coarse as well as fine focusing knobs are there. Then we have an illuminating light source. After that, we have a diaphragm of control for the condenser lens. Then we have an stage to hold the sample. And we have an objective lens. It have 4500x and 10x, and we have an body tube transmit and an ocular lens. Here it is binocular. Two objective lens are there. So these are the different parts of an ideal optical microscope or light microscope. So the compound microscope, the image from the objective lens will be magnified by the ocular lens, and total magnification power will be objective lens into the ocular lens. So here we will use a light source, and the light source, by using condenser, we will converge the light source on the specimen, and the rays from the specimen will focus through the objective lens, and it is passing through the projector or ocular lens, and finally in our eye the image will be formed. So this is the real physics of a microscope. Light enter through the condenser, and it will converge on the focus of the object, and this rays will enter through the objective lens, and it will form an image of real image of the object which is inverted, and this image will real image which is inverted image will act as an object for the second lens, that is ocular lens, and ocular lens will again magnify this image, and we can see a magnified image of object. So this is the real diagram which show the pathway of the rays. See, this is the object. Okay, so the light rays from the object will focus by objective lens, and some refraction will be taking place here, because here light is entering from air to glass, and then from glass to air, so some bending property will be there. Then after that, it will converge in a position where it will form an image of the object, that is the real image. The real image will be always inverted, And this image one of the object will act as an object for the second lens, that is eyepiece lens. But what, see one thing, here the rays which are originated from the image one or real image will not converge anywhere. So we will extrapolate this rays to here and to meet this rays. So where it will form an objective, where it will form an image which is inverted, also magnified image of the object can be observed. So that is the physics of microscopy. So in same picture only, this is object, this is objective lens, and it will focus here to form a real image that is inverted, and this real image will act as an object for the eyepiece lens, and it will form an final image, that is virtual image, that is magnified virtual image will be formed. Now light microscope have an objective lens of 10x, 45x and 100x. This 10x is used for the scanning of the microorganism or minute subjects and to find out the subject for coarse focusing, and 45x is used for to focus an object for fine focusing, and oil immersion for exact fine focusing or to enlarge the view of objects. Now the role of condenser to focus the light on the object plane and ensure the adequate intensity. The height of a condenser can control the uniformity of brightness and contrast to minimize the stray light, and indirectly angle of light entering the objective lens can be controlled. Now let's see what will happen if we are not using oil immersion. So this is the condenser. So by using condenser, we will focus this rays to an object where it will enter into a glass slide, and from that glass slide again it will enter to air. So when compare the refractive index of air with the glass, the refractive index of air is very very less. So what will happen, this rays will reflected or refracted out of the objective lens, it will not enter to the objective lens, so it will not focus any objects. So if we didn't use the oil, it will not enter into the objective lens, as well as it will, we cannot see any images of the objects. So that's to avoid this refraction, we are using oil immersion. Now coming to the next one, bright field microscope. The basic of microscopy is same, small modification will be there. As the name indicate, in bright field microscope, we will get a dark object in a bright background. Bright field, we will get a bright field and a dark object. Reflected light will not enter into the objective lens, only transmitted light will be enter into the objective lens and it will focus. So this is the diagram of a bright field microscope. We have a light and we have a condenser lens, and we will focus this lens into specimen, and the light rays which will passes through the objective lens and it will form an image on eye, magnified image of an eye, and we will get an observation like in a bright field, we will get a dark microorganism or dark object. So this is the bright field microscope. This will be the observation. In a bright field, we will get a dark specimen. Now, what are the limitations of bright field microscope? It have a very low contrast of biological samples and low apparent resolution due to the blurring appearance of out of focus material, and it have a resolution power of 0.2 micrometer at the best, and can be used for the recognition of cell, not for fine details. And what are the advantages of bright field microscope? Because of its simplicity, the basic equipment can be used for the bright field microscope, and no sample preparation is required, so we can view the live cells, and it is a convenient and relatively inexpensive and available microscope, normal microscope only, bright field microscope. Next one is dark field microscope. It is just opposite of that of bright field microscope. See, in bright field microscope, we will get a bright field with dark object. In dark field microscope, we will get just opposite of that. That means we will get a dark field and a illuminated objects. So brightly illuminated specimen will be observed in dark field. Here reflected light will be used, will be enter into the objective lens instead of transmitted light. In bright field it was transmitted light, but in dark field we will use reflected light, which is will enter into the objective lens. But we have to modify something in dark field microscope. So that is the essential part, which is the dark field condenser with a central circular stop, which will illuminate the object with a cone of light without letting any ray of light to fall directly into the objective lens. So a cone of light is focused on the specimen and it will be get illuminated, so that what will happen, the light rays falling on the object are reflected or scattered onto the objective lens, which will result that the object appear as self-luminous against a dark background. So that will be the observation of dark field microscope. So like this only the observation will be there. In a dark background we will get an illuminating specimens. Here only small change is there. In dark condenser we will use an occulting disc will be used. Rest of the all the lenses will be same as that mentioned in the light microscope. So here we will use an opaque lens. So what will happen, the only reflected light, okay, only reflected light will be passes through the objective lens and it will form an image. So this will be the observation of dark field microscope. In a dark field we will get a bright specimen. Let's see what are the limitations of dark field microscope. It have a low light intensity in final images of many biological samples and low apparent resolution due to blurry appearance of out of focus objects. And it have advantages like it will clearly show an even transparent object in the sample, and due to the simplicity of setup we can use this dark field microscope with the basic equipments, and no sample preparation is required for the dark field microscope, so we can use for live as well as unstained biological samples. So these are the advantages of dark field microscope. Now coming to the phase contrast microscope. Phase contrast microscope will make more noticeable diffraction of light that passes through the specimen. The phase contrast is a widely used technique that will convert the light difference in the refractive index and the cell density into easily detected variations of light intensity, and is excellent way to observe the live things. As the physical property of the of this direct light have changed, the interference with the diffracted light occur, resulting in phase contrast image. Here we have to modify something more than the dark field microscopy. Here in the condenser lens we have to use an annular stop with opaque disc with a thin transparent ring, which will produce a hollow cone of light. That is the main modification. As this cone passes through the cell, some light rays are bent due to the variation in the density of the cell and refractive index within the specimen, and the retarded by about 1/4 of the wavelengths. This deviated light is focused into to form an image of objects. And then phase contrast microscopy is mainly used to study microbial motility and determining the shape of living cells and detecting the bacterial components of endospores and inclusion bodies containing poly beta hydroxy butyrate and poly meta phosphate and sulfur and other substances. So this is the modification. In condenserless lens, we have to use an condenser annule with a ring-like structure, and also we have to use an phase plate just after the objective lens, and here we are connected with an image plate. So this is the basic difference. Here we have to use an annular diaphragm, after that a condenser lens as usual as that of a light microscope. Then we will focus it on light on the object, and here refracted and diffracted light alt passes through the objective, and unrefracted light will be unaltered by the specimen, and it will be passes through the diffraction plate, and then it passes through the ocular lens, and it will form a density in the contrast. So that is means the phase contrast according to the density as well as the refractive index of the cell. We will get dense areas dark and light areas bright. So that is the phase contrast vision of a phase contrast microscopy. So this is the flow diagram. You have to write only these diagrams, no need to write the compound structure of microscope, which consists of ocular lens and base, all that you don't have to write for the examination. You have to just write the light source and annular diaphragm and a condenser, and through the it will passes through the specimen and then through objective lens, and an retarded light passes through the phase plate, and we will get an image plate as observation of the objects. This is a diagram which show phase contrast as well as bright field microscopy of the same cell. Here we will get bright field, and here we can see the phase contrast. The darker one will be the parts of microorganism with higher density. So that is the phase contrast microscopy. This is the difference in the observation of phase contrast dark field and phase contrast microscopy of same objects, some fibers. So here bright field will be there and dark object will be there. Here dark field will be there and bright or illuminating object will be there. Here the object are seen according to the variation in the density and refractive index of the material. So here is the comparison between bright field, dark field and phase contrast construction of the microscopy. Here we are not using any modification in bright field modification. Here just condenser lens, then specimen, then an objective lens and ocular lens. Here but in dark field microscope we will use an opaque disc just before the condenser lens, and here only reflected light will be passes through the objective lens. And in case of phase contrast microscope, we are using an annular diaphragm which have a ring like structure inside, so that it will focus both refracted as well as diffracted light which will passes through the objective lens, and it will form an object with the difference in that refractive index as well as the density of the cell.